If you find something that's going to hit the Earth, deflecting it is actually relatively easy. Because if you find it many years before it hits the Earth, say 10, 20 years before it hits the Earth, remember the Earth is going to go around the sun 10 or 20 times, as will that object. So these things have a long ways to travel before they hit, and that means a tiny, tiny, tiny change in their orbit will keep it, something from hitting the Earth.
You just slow the Earth down a little bit.
Yes, that's exactly right. So everybody needs to...
There's a great new Chinese movie coming out about this. Actually.
But for those of you who took physics, if we all jump at the same time, we don't change the velocity of the Earth because we're connected to it, right? You need an external momentum. So what you actually
boring
do...
Answer.
Yeah, the boring answer is to change the orbits of the asteroid by a tiny amount. And one of the things that we had been urging since the foundation of the B612 Foundation is that we human beings ought to test that technology because we know how to do it. And in fact, NASA is now going to do that test. It's called the DART mission. Again, about 2022, I believe it is. We're just going to actually run a small spacecraft into an asteroid, and that is actually sufficient in the mass majority of cases to keep an asteroid from hitting the Earth, provided you have notice. Now,
right.
Now I don't want to go back. Now, back to your question, predicting that something's going to hit requires you be able to calculate, orbits very, very accurately and know the uncertainties in order to calculate, what are the chances that this thing hits. And I don't want to give the impression that we're the only ones doing. There are other people that think of, they calculate these things and they put these things in big tables. Okay, but think of what the difference is between Google Maps and if somebody listed for you every restaurant in New York City in a big table. What's the difference? And why was Google Maps so important to commerce, to things like Lyft and Uber? They all started by using Google Maps, Yelp, Airbnb. Because they didn't, the visual mapping part, the underlying machinery was built for them, and they could just build on top of it. And so what we want to do is allow people to build navigation tools for the solar system without having to do all the heavy lifting, because 99.99% of the calculation is exactly the same and can happen in the background. And so we want to provide that as a service.